I wonder if entrepreneurship is worth it. I wonder if
getting involved in some form of sales is worth it. Guys, we're not waiting for a stimulus package. We're not waiting for the Republicans or the Democrats. No, we showed our guys how to build a business. So for moments like this, they're so glad that they're in control of their income. The biggest benefit of our guys that we've coached and mentored as entrepreneurs in the insurance industry is that they are in control of their income. And guess what? Business is booming. Our guys, our entrepreneurs, the guys that we've been coaching and mentoring, they're getting paid over $478,000 in commissions. What's going on, everybody? Mighty Smart Guy Matt Cipolla here, just grabbing some air outside. People think that when it turns, I don't know, what is it, 45, 50 degrees outside? People think that it's summertime. How many of y'all feeling cabin fever? It seems that my internet works better when I come from the outside to go to the inside. Yes, it's working, Antina. It's weird. My internet is weird. Looks like the coronavirus is inside the Wi-Fi. So I had to go to regular AT&T. But BB, how you doing? How's everybody doing? Let me go back inside. Got some air. Let me go back inside. How many of you guys feeling cabin fever? Yeah, it is, BB. Definitely summertime. Let me close my garage. It is definitely cabin fever. How you guys doing? Good, everybody doing good? All right, Filipino house. You gotta take care of the shoes in the front. How do you guys do that at your house? Oh man, stock market today jumped 2100 points, the biggest gain in the history of the stock market ever. Listen man, one of the things I know, you know, coming out the military, coming from regular jobs, is that it is a different mindset when working from the office versus the house. Big reason why. Hey, Jojo, say hi to everybody. Hey, Jojo reading a book, you reading a book? Good for you. So biggest distractions of the house. How many of you guys would agree with this? Right here, refrigerator, bunch of food. Distraction number one. Distraction number two, pantry. That's where my Chips Ahoy are at. Shh, I love Chips Ahoy. Don't tell my trainer Milton. He's trying to wean me off of Chips Ahoy and cookies. Distraction number three, big old TV. And if that wasn't enough, let me show you downstairs. Big distraction, mind you. My family was born. My wife, my sister, and I were born in Chicago. My family comes from the Philippines. My wife was born in Sacramento. It's downstairs in the basement. Another distraction. Boom, right there. Media room. Woo, another distraction. Bar area. Definitely, that's where all the drinks are at. All right, so many distractions. So the point of this video, the point of this episode, is to give you some of my thoughts, tips about how to work out of the house. Because listen, coming out the military, coming out the Marine Corps, working out of the house was very new to me. I'm used to being in the field, I'm used to being out and about. When I was in Marine Corps, I was in a helicopter, I was training, running and gunning, hangar, turning wrenches, cleaning weapons. I was involved, I was doing my thing hands-on. And then when I left the Marine Corps, I had three jobs. I was a Jiffy Lube technician, I was a lifeguard at the YMCA, and then I was a server at Olive Garden. Anyway, make a long story short, a completely different mindset when working out of the house versus the office or your place of business. And now that we're in this quarantine, now that we're in this #stay home, working from home is not only more important, but also right now for most states, most people, it's really required, or your job is finding ways for you to telecommute or video commute. So I want to give you some thoughts and ideas of what that transition like from a mental standpoint, but also from a practicality standpoint. So if you're working from the house, these are little blinds. I love these blinds here. There's the home office right here. The house. Guys, we found a perfect time to move into this house. It was, I think, November, December, we moved into this house, but we were living in a three-bedroom house. It was like our starter house. My wife and I, we were boyfriend and girlfriend, then we got engaged, and we got married. But that was our starter house of 3 years, 4 years. And all we did at that first house, we focused in on our business, invested into our business, reinvested back into our business, stacked up cash. And then when the right opportunity presented itself, boom, we bought a house. And this is what you're looking at. This is what you're looking at, a 7,500 square foot house. Let me show you the backyard here right quick. This is our backyard. This is the patio area. Backyard is a golf course. I mean, it's nuts, it's crazy. Listen, when I was growing up in Chicago, Johanna, you might like this one because we got a chef's kitchen right there. It's a wolf's range. But I remember cooking breakfast in Chicago and I opened a window and I'd see my neighbors right in their kitchen having breakfast. You know, proximity of properties and neighborhoods in Chicago so close. It's just a walkway between homes. So what a blessing that entrepreneurship has allowed us the opportunity to not only work out of the office, but also, if need be, work out of the house. So a couple of thoughts. Johanna, she's going stir crazy. Whew, I know the feeling. So our guys, our entrepreneurs, the guys that we've been coaching and mentoring, they're getting paid, man. Let me flip this around real quick. The guys gotten paid so far this month, over $478,000 in commissions we paid out so far this month. So, you know, some of the people say, you know what? I wonder if entrepreneurship is worth it. I wonder if getting involved in some form of sales is worth it. By the way, every part of business is sales. If you're an entrepreneur, you're a chef, right, Johanna? If you're a pastor, you're a teacher, you're a leader, you're a community organizer, you're an activist, guess what you're good at? You're good at sales. And so the benefit of what we've coached our guys, that's why they're making this type of money, $478,000 in a month that we're paying out to our guys. Guys, we're not waiting for a stimulus package. We're not waiting for the Republicans or the Democrats. No, we showed our guys how to build a business. So for moments like this, they're so glad that they're in control of their income. The biggest benefit of our guys that we've coached and mentored as entrepreneurs in the insurance industry is that they are in control of their income. And guess what? Business is booming. Business is exploding. My wife right now has been back to back at the office. And so say, Matt, so if you have you have a 12,000 square foot office, how come you're not at the office? Well, here's what happened. My mother is 74 years old. My father, the kid's grandfather, is 79 years old. So they're at the high risk category of this whole coronavirus, that COVID-19 thing. So we told them, Mom, Dad, stay home. Just put yourself up, stay home, quarantine. We want you safe, we want you healthy. We don't want nothing happen to you, obviously. If we can help something to make sure that nothing happens to you, we just want you to stay home. Don't worry about babysitting, nothing like that. But you know, mom being mom, she's like, no, I need to come home. I need to come see my grandbabies, take care of my grandbabies. And by the way, my mother is not only a Filipino mom, but she's also, guess what? She works as a living. She used to work for a living. She's a nurse. And so anyway, make a long story short, we told her stay home. Our nanny said that her husband came home with a flu-like symptoms, and we're like, whoa, what are you talking about? And so he went to go get coronavirus tested, and we won't find out the results until Wednesday, Thursday. So we told our nanny, stay home. It's okay, take time off, go home. So my wife and I, since we built a business and we create systems and processes, she can go to the office or I go to the office, and one of us stays home so we can watch the kids. The kids are our babies upstairs. He's taking a nap right now. That's why I'm doing this video. But we're so glad and thankful that we've built a business in an industry that allows us to work from home. So maybe you've got the same opportunity, whatever industry that you're in. I know maybe our PHP family's on here. Maybe our non-PHP family's on here too as well. But if you're in a business or a career or an enterprise that allows you to work from home, here's some of the practices, some of the five things of how to more effectively work from home. So number one, you gotta treat working at the house like you're actually going to work, okay? So wake up at a certain time frame. You get up at a certain time frame. Don't take for granted they're just working out of the house and they just, you know what, let me just kind of roll out of bed. No. If you're used to getting up at 5, 6 o'clock in the morning, guess what? If you're working out of the house, still get up at 5, 6 o'clock in the morning. Well, man, I don't have to commute. I don't have to do any of this. Great, use that time to read, personally develop, catch up on podcasts, improve your self-development. You know, one of the things I've been reading here lately is anything by John Maxwell. Anything that he's written, John Maxwell, one of the books I'm reading from John Maxwell right now is Developing the Leaders Around You, right? So some of the things that he said here, without each person's conviction that the cause is worth the price, what cause are you in? The battle will never won and a team will not succeed. There must be commitment. So our team is committed to business. I got to invoke commitment, trust, and work ethic that times like this, when everybody's scared, everybody's panicked, everybody's worried. We've done webinars, by the way, we've done webinars every day this week and going on to the next 8 days, 10 days, we've shifted in how we do business as an insurance firm. And it's exciting because a lot of guys are now finally exposed. So working from home exposes you. And I'll get to that in a second. But I want to share with you that working out of the house, you got to treat working out of the house like you're going to work, like you're going to your job, like you're going to your place of business, like you're going to your office. So if you're used to getting up at 5, 6, 7 o'clock in the morning, stay doing that, okay? Stay doing that, because if you don't stay doing that, then what happens is instead of your standards staying high and raising your standard, what happens is you lower your standards if you just kind of mosey up out of bed. So my encouragement to you, one thing you ought to get, I don't know what I'm doing, is I still get up at 5, 6, 7 o'clock in the morning. I still get my 5, 6 hours of sleep a night. I still get it in. I have my process about how I go to sleep. By the way, my friend Rodolfo Vargas, I think, might be watching this. And he says, Matt, turn off the TV, turn off everything, just be silent. It's my roommate when we go travel. But treat your opportunity to work from home like you're actually going to the office, like you're going to your place of business. In other words, whatever your morning routine is, what is your guys' morning routine? What is your morning routine when you go to the work, when you go to office? My morning routine, like in the morning, I like to shower. Do you like to shower? I like to shower like you're going to the office. So don't skip on the shower. You know, go get your hair done, wash your hair, wash your body, hygiene. Well, these people say, well, I could just work from home with my pajamas. Yeah, that's an option. That's an option if you want to work out of your pajamas, but I like to be hygienic. For me, I like to be clean and organized. Because for me, to me, that's kind of like a routine. It's kind of like a part of the process. It's like an NFL player, an NBA player, putting on their gear, putting on their uniform, putting on their Dre beats and listening to music in preparation for the game. See, that's what for me is my routine. Treat it like you're going to the office. Ladies, if you do your makeup, do your makeup. Matt, but I'm out of the house, but do you feel great when you put on your makeup, when you get your hair done, when you got your clothes on? Listen, every morning I can tell my wife is getting ready because it just smells so good in the room, right? My wife is just getting done. I can tell my baby's getting ready for going to the office. And even though she might be at the house, she's still getting ready. The room just fills with makeup, perfume, shampoo, soap, boom. The body knows it's getting ready to work. And so guys, line your stuff up. Line your stuff up. Whatever your routine is, I'll share with you a little. I'll just share with you guys, okay? Let me go upstairs here real quick and let me share with you a little bit about our routine. Instead of just telling you, let me show you. So we're going upstairs here. There's a lot of stairs to this house, man. By the way, this house, so daggone big. If I forget something, whew. Okay, so here, check this out. This is the master bedroom. TV in here, by the way, it's off. This is back over here. This is Sheena's routine. It's my wife's routine. She's got her little meditation area here. Little quiet room. Okay, that's Sheena's routine. Right back here is balcony. Right when it gets a little warmer, I'm gonna be out here drinking my coffee. Late at night, I'll be smoking some of my cigars. Right? By the way, what's your routine? Do you make up your bed? When you get up in the morning, do you make your bed? Make your bed in the morning. By the way, for some reason, when you make your bed up in the morning, you're just more organized. So let me show you right here. This is the, let me turn on the lights here. It's the master, guys, this is the master bathroom. It's the master bathroom, the chandelier up there, master bathroom. It's over there is a Sheena's bathroom. All right, this is my wife's bathroom right here. Right, she does her thing. Over here is mine. I don't know, guys. Maybe you guys can visualize. There's a toilet. So, you know, just kind of visualize with me, you know, what I do first thing in the morning. So, la, 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 la. Oh, guess what? No need for toilet paper. Guess why? Because right next door, we've converted this water fountain into an alternative form of toilet paper. God. Boom. See, that used to be a water fountain. Because when I used to, you know, do my business, I used to get thirsty. We converted this water fountain into an alternative form of toilet paper. I'm just kidding. You guys know I'm messing with you. You know, this is the shower right here. Boom. There's the rain shower, shower head, 4 different steam jets. I call the shower check a crack, man, because you walk in there, it's like a car wash. It'll check every crack you got in your body. But guys, listen, this master bathroom was bigger than my first 2-bedroom apartment in Chicago.
So anyway, the reason why I'm sharing this with you, because every time I walk in this house, like, it blows my mind too. So, like, I live here. Yes, that's because you decided to take charge of your finances. That's because you started to take charge of your credit score. That's because you started to take charge of your income. That's because you didn't listen to the naysayers. And when I'm walking around this master bathroom, I'm reminded that this was bigger than my first apartment in Chicago. This whole entire master bedroom, it got more plumbing, it got more mirrors. I get up in the morning, man, my routine. What's my routine, right? Get the J's organized. Got my suits organized. Colors, shirts, everything organized. Why? Because that's my routine. Because for me, guys, listen, I'm not the most systematic person. By the way, there's Jojo. Jojo's reading still. You go, boy. You like reading, huh?
Yeah, I'm just following you.
You're just following me?
Yeah.
How come you follow me?
So, like, snuck up behind you in the room, and you're walking in. I'm, like, right there at the stairs, like, spying, and then I just, like, walk all the way there. I go close to there, and I come back, and I sit right here.
I love it.
BB
says, if I don't do my morning routine, I feel disorganized. Yes. So how? I totally agree. So I want you guys to consider being organized first thing in the morning. Let me blast through this because I know my son's about to wake up from his nap. So that's the morning routine. Not maybe you guys are visualizing what I do in the morning now. Anyway, number two, you got to have an outcome. Man, I'm gonna make 100 phone calls, 200 phone calls, 25 phone calls, whatever the phone calls are. I'm gonna make sure I invite 5, 10, 15 guests to a webinar. I gotta send a 25 LinkedIn, social media. I gotta drop some people some DMs. Whatever that goal is, you gotta be proactive. Here's what happens when working from home. Your routine gets exposed. The people that used to go to a job and used to be getting told to do something, they get exposed when working from the house. Why? Because there's nobody telling you what to do from the house. So for those that weren't self-starters, that you were an entrepreneur, that you kind of took it for granted, that, you know, you're waiting for somebody else to kind of do something, your manager, your technician, your other leaders with inside your different departments. If you didn't have a routine, if you didn't have a self-starter, self-inspirational, self-motivated, self-thinking type attitude and capacity, guess what happens? You get exposed. And guess who starts taking over? The people that were taking initiative, the people that were inspired, that they went through all the different things. You say, you know what? I got to get a job done. Those are the people that surpass others versus the one that needs to get told what to do. So the people that have an employee mentality working from home instead of like an entrepreneur attitude, you know, because listen, just because you may not be in business for yourself, you may be working for a boss, but you have an entrepreneur attitude, right? Which is the same mindset of an entrepreneur without putting your money and credit and reputation at risk. You're an entrepreneur because you're climbing up the corporate ladder, but if you have the opportunity to work from home, you gotta be more goal setting oriented. You have to have a daily discipline in terms of what is the outcome for today. So therefore, you wake up, you work out of the office. Here's my desk. If I'm working out of the office, I got my goals, man. I know what to do today. I have an outcome for today. That way, you can quantify whether or not you have a good day or a bad day. You know what to work on for tomorrow. When it's past business hours, you know, man, I got to work on this stuff. I got to ship this stuff. I got to step on this. I got to bone up on this. Boom. I know what to work on for tomorrow. I could improve. And here's the thing, guys, too, as well. Guys and gals, I fail a lot in my day. So don't think this is the perfect thing for me. Because there's certain things that I'm going on because it's going to lead up to point number three. You got to eliminate distractions. What is distractions? See these doors? When my kids know that these doors are closed, when these doors are closed, that means Poppy is working. It's game on. What'd you do? Open up all the drawers. What? What'd you do? Huh? What'd you do? Here's your job.
Babe, what are you doing? Jojo, what's mommy doing?
Cooking something?
What? Do not knock on the door. Every 5 seconds, Poppy. If those doors are closed, you know Poppy's working. You know mommy's working. If these doors are closed in the home office, we're working. By the way, this is what creates our house to be tax deductible. Well, at least a portion of the house.
Not the entire house, but a portion of the house. So you gotta eliminate distractions. That every 5 seconds, your kids or your neighbors can't be disturbing you because you're working. You're getting the job done. You got a goal to hit. And you're focusing on that goal. The thing there too is making sure you close all the tabs on your social media or things that are distracting you, because I remember sometimes you go on one thing, next thing you know, you get caught up in a stupid video, and it's entertaining for 30 seconds. Next thing you know, 5 minutes is gone because you're getting mentally back on track. So working out of the house is so critical and how you eliminate distractions. Otherwise you get caught up, and next thing you know, you realize, man, I didn't get stuff done today. I didn't even get through half my calls. I even forgot about this type of stuff. And by the way, part of that eliminating distractions is these reminders. You have to have these reminders that kind of pop up. Boom, boom, boom. Call in 15 minutes, call in 5 minutes, call this number. And part of that process too, let's say you're doing a webinar, in the calendar portion, make sure you put the link or the phone number inside that appointment. So therefore it's easy for you to reference that appointment and just call the number or hit a click and then you're logged into a Zoom or a webinar. That's how you maximize your day and how you effectively use your calendar. Fourth thing to effectively work better out of the house, accountability. This morning, we just got off of a call with our mentor, CEO, founder, host of Valuetainment, Patrick McDavid. And every week he holds us accountable to our numbers, to our performance. In conjunction to that, I also hold myself accountable to my team, my business, the leadership group I have across the country. I have to hold myself accountable to my communication with them, my response back to them, the people we serve, the people we're building, the people that we're pushing up. We hold ourselves accountable to them. Well, man, I don't have much of a business. Great. You're holding yourself accountable to the future business you're about to build. But it starts now. That discipline starts now. That anticipation, that planning, that big thinking starts now. That's what you hold yourself accountable to. Sometimes you need a accountability system, like we have GroupMe. Like we hold ourselves when we perform, we do something, boom. We report it. Hey, we got a result today. I'm inching my business forward today. Boom, I'm getting it done today. Please send me some love. And boom, our guys send some love. They send some great job, keep it up. That's accountability. Last one, last but not least, is that you have to have some form of technology home support. For example, when I'm making calls at the house, I got these beats. I have these on my ear. I make calls this way. I don't like being held up like this. It's tough, it's tight. I'm like all caught up here. I like to walk around my office. I like to walk around the house, make phone calls, interact. Pretend like I'm at the office, because that's how I am at the office. If need be, I go into the garage or walk outside, but this is where I make phone calls, over here. So therefore my body's relaxed. It's like I'm in an effective conversation. Sometimes if need be, I'll walk the dog. I'll make some non-essential conversations, but the conversation that I need to close or some form of financial trajectory or business expansion about to happen, these are the calls I make in the office, okay? Focused inside the conversation. And so part of that technology too as well, make sure if you haven't done so already, you might want to boost your internet. You want to boost the bandwidth. So therefore your communication, your Wi-Fi, your video conferences don't get choppy and laggy, just like mine was. That's why I referred to a different Wi-Fi signal, because I tried doing this for the first couple of times. Instead of getting frustrated about it, I just shifted to the next signal because I got the bandwidth to do it. The third thing about that, you might want to invest in something like IT support. There's a website out there called Geeks On Site. I have my own IT support, but if I didn't have my own IT guy come here to the house, I go to this website called Geeks On Site. And there's local people potentially in your, and by the way, this is not a promotion. I don't make any money off Geeks On Site. This is not an affiliate thing. I'm just sending you a resource that you should check out. If you need IT support, we use Geeks On Site. So a guy can come to the office, come to your home office, check out your internet, check out your Wi-Fi, optimize everything, clean up your computer, wipe off all the things that doesn't optimize your hardware. So therefore you have an optimized computer and phone experience. So therefore you're running your business. So with that being said, guys, I wanna know your thoughts. I wanna know your ideas. I wonder what it is that you're thinking. Drop it in the comment section below. If you're watching this here on Facebook, make sure you like our business page. We got more stuff like this every day that we're helping people work from home, create a new enterprise for themselves, generate a new stream of income, consider a different career. I'm in the insurance industry. And by the way, everybody's calling me right now because, well, we got some stuff to do. But listen, guys, I wanna know your ideas. I wanna know your comments. Please share this to help other people work from home more effectively. Tina, thanks for coming on and watching. KT, hey man, how's your son doing? Jackie Jackson, goal setting discipline. Jesse Moon is powerful, have an outcome and quantify, correct? Give you guys some love here. Reggie Anderson, good job, good to see you, bro. Look forward to seeing you in a webinar tonight. By the way, for those of you, let me close out with this. For those of you who is like, you know what, I'm not waiting on the federal government to give me a stimulus package, I'm not waiting for anything else to help me make more money. Well, we have a webinar tonight. Please drop me a DM. We'll send you the link. Drop your information here or check back here, because we're going to be posting the link in the comment section below how you can get on board to our webinar to show you how to build a business, work out of the house. By the way, for the first 3 years, I learned how to work my business out of the house. when I was a single father with custody of my three kids, and I was able to make $100,000, $200,000, $300,000 a year using these principles, using this industry, the platform, the work that we do helping families with finances. I was able to do that as a single parent. We're gonna have some single fathers, single mothers. We're gonna have some parents here tomorrow, I think the next day, to talk about it in the next Facebook Live event, what it meant for them to take these principles, to take these habits, to take this opportunity, to find a new career, to find a new habit, to find a new industry, to bring home the bacon. So therefore, you can get through this pandemic crisis with confidence, clarity, playing offense. So therefore, when everybody somewhat gets back to normal, you're already here, right? Because by the way, the whole world right now is on pause. The whole world is on pause. It's your opportunity right now to be in the crowd, but not be of the crowd. Let me repeat that one more time. It's your opportunity right now to be in the crowd, but not of the crowd, to rise up above. So therefore, when the world kind of comes back to normal and moving forward again, you're like 5, 10, 15 steps ahead. I'd love for that to happen to you, but that way you get some financial elevation, some financial distance over what's going on here, because a lot of financial troubles are right here. But I'd love for you to have your financial income up here, because therefore when financial troubles kind of creep up, boom, you just cut a check. Financial troubles start coming up, boom, you just cut a check. Listen, there's nothing more powerful than understanding that cash flow, your credit is king. That being said, thanks for tuning in. If you haven't done so already, make sure you like our business page. If you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you follow and subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you're on Instagram, make sure you follow me at MoneySmartGuy. That being said, guys, thanks for tuning in. Appreciate you guys. Stay healthy and stay safe. Till we meet again. Continue to live smart. Continue to love smart. Be money smart today.